forecast calling for a fine afternoon here in Atlanta. Stay tuned for Braves baseball starting now. The southern skies are clear and it's a great afternoon for baseball at Turner Field in Atlanta as MLB The Show gets set for another edition of Major League Baseball. We've got a good one on tap here as it'll be the St. Louis Cardinals taking on the Atlanta Braves. And hi again, folks. Alongside Dave Campbell and Eric Karros, I'm Matt Vasgersian getting set for an intriguing matchup here. The guys will join me in a moment. John Jay will step to the plate now as we're ready to get this one underway. And we are underway from Turner Field as the first pitch misses this afternoon, taken for ball one. Jay, a pretty good story for these Cards a year ago. Claimed that center field job following the trade of Colby Rasmus to Toronto and really ran with it afterwards.
Yeah, he sort of entered the spring as the fourth outfielder between Holiday, Rasmus, and Berkman, but when it was all said and done, he only missed three games all year.
And he lays off for a ball, 2-1. And Jay's one of those guys that does a little bit of everything. A little bit of pop, a little bit of speed, up over 300 for a majority of the year. He's a good guy to have around.
Well, I think as a pitcher, you'd prefer that first batter to pop up or ground out meekly, but bang, he hits this rocket right to the shortstop. I hope that's not a sign of things to come.
Carlos Beltran set the plate now. He looks at strike one.
Well, this won't be a four-hour game with a strike zone like that.
Another fastball. Another full strike. Nothing in two now.
You can tell he's still frustrated after that first called strike. It's still on his mind.
Fastball, strike three calls, and he's getting close to trigger and there are two away. Matt Holliday will dig in now, starting left fielder on last season's NL All-Star team. Now here's the ball hit hard on the ground to second. Up with it is Ugla. Throw in time, and the side is retired. So not much happening here in the top half of the first. And now the Braves will get their initial shot. Now the starting lineup for the host Braves looks like this. Again, brought to us by State Farm. Swing and a ground ball towards the hole. And base hit. So the leadoff man reaches here to start the bottom of the first.
Yeah, and this afternoon's off to a good start with these guys already. They had a 1-2-3 top half, and now they've got their leadoff man on here.
Martin Pato steps in now. A late swing here, but is hit hard to the right side. He gets fouled, 0-1. Swing and a miss, it's 0-2.
And you've really got to be patient when you're a number two hitter.
pitch fastball swung on and missed 0-1.
And he's been stuck on first over there, but he may decide with two outs that he can't wait any longer.
And a swing and a miss is on the falls behind here quickly, 0-2.
I gotta tell you, if I'm on the mound, why put one in the strike zone here? He hasn't shown any discipline at all on the first two pitches.
Good fastball swung on and missed for strike three, and the inning is over. Braves fail to score. Alan Craig leads things off now in the top half of the second. And the good spot for that pitch is it's chopped foul. But low with the ball and a strike.
Yeah, and after throwing so few pitches in the first, he might want to vary his locations a bit.
And he looks at one in there, 1-2. The two balls and two strikes now. Foul into the feet and left. And a full count as that misses. It's 3-2 now. And this is lined into left field for their first hit of the ball game. David Freed will get his first shot out of here. And he gets ahead 0-1. Freed, originally property of the Padres organization. Another one of those guys that there always seems to be a few of every year that have good regular seasons and then save their best work for the postseason.
Yeah, one of only six guys to win the MVP award in both the Championship Series and the World Series. You've probably heard of the numbers by now, but his 21 postseason RBIs were an all-time record.
On to Freeman, and they get the double play.
Boy, and this is a dream for both the pitcher and second baseman. A nice, easy two-hopper that's turned into the standard issue 4-6-3. They do not come a lot easier than that.
Yadier Molina to take his first cut to the ball game here. Here's the first offering. And just lucky to make contact on that one as it's chopped foul. Having success with the fastball here, it's 0-2 now. Even down 0-2 here. Molina, the second toughest to strike out in the National League last year. Just does manage to get a piece there if this is bound foul. No score here as we play inning number two. And this one's hit on the ground, but foul. Another 0-2 coming. Swing and a liner through second. This will be folded out there at second base, and that'll be that. Brian McCann will lead things off here, as they'll have 5, 6, and 7 due up to start the home second. We had to be looking for something else to start the at-bat. It's 0-1. McCann, still one of the top power hitting options at catcher in the National League. His 24 home runs, 6 better than the number 2 man, Miguel Montero of Arizona. And now pitch on the way. Fastball that's taken the other way toward left center and fairly deep. Therefore, it is Holiday, and he's got it. One gone. Jason Heyward will be the batter. First pitch coming from Wainwright. number 19 will step in now. Fastball bounces up to the plate and it's taken for a ball. Swing and a miss as he ramps up on the fastball 1-1.
And with the pitcher on deck, you'd love to get this guy here and make the pitcher lead off the third.
2-1. The 2-1. And a fastball is hit on the ground towards short. And Schumacher covering, and that'll end the inning. So no runs here on a base hit, no errors, and one man left aboard. We'll go now to the top of the third, and we are tied 0-0. Skip Schumacher, ready to go here as we begin the third. And looks like he got the call there on the pitch inside. It's 0-1. Schumacher, 283 a year ago, two home runs, 38 RBI. And this is swung on and lifted down the left field line, but it'll get back into the crowd as he jumps ahead of him now, 0-2. Hit on the ground toward first. And the underhanded throw gets him for the out. Pete Cosmo will be the batter. Start him with a high strike here on the fastball on the outside corner. It's 0-1.
Now that he's fully loose out there, you can see he's getting a little more zip on that fastball than he had coming out of the gate.
Here's one that misses high. It's 1-1.
And that thing looked like it was still rising at the end.
Outside, 2-1. Third inning, no score to this point. Here's the 2-1 pitch. And he's fallen behind now, 3-1. Now a ball hit high down the left field line, but back in amongst the spectators, foul. Now a slider's hit on the ground for a second. There to take it is Ugla. On the framing at first, and there are two away now. Adam Wainwright will stand in for the first time here. And he'll start in with a fastball that misses down and away for a ball. 1-0. 1-0 on the way. And that's in there for a strike, 1-1. Up high, 2-1 now.
This guy is almost no threat up at the plate. I mean, you could get away with fastballs right down the middle if you wanted to.
And that pitch comes over to catch the corner. It's 2-2 now.
Wow, he is spotting that fastball on a dime here early on.
And he'll miss down low in the dirt, so his work is full now. It's 3-2.
And the one thing you cannot afford to do is to extend this inning by walking the pitcher.
Making a liner back through the box. And that is in there for a two-out base knock. John Jay will try it once more. He lined out to start the ball game. A fastball off the plate away. It's ball one.
And after you allow a base hit to the pitcher, you've got to bounce back quickly and put it out of your mind.
2-0.
And here's a case where you can just sit on fastballs. If you don't get one, just take it.
Too high as he misses again here, and it's 3-0 now.
Now, he looked good to start the inning, but then a hit and a 3-0 count have turned the tables on.
That one's in there, 3-1. Swung on and hit softly on a line, but foul. pitch. That's the ball. It misses for ball four, so that's going to move a runner into scoring position now with two away. Carlos Beltran will get another shot, called out on strikes his first time around. And he catches the inside corner for a called strike, nothing in one. The Beltran, a big pickup in the offseason here for St. Louis. Even 300 hitter with the Mets and Giants a year ago, 22 home runs, 84 driven in.
Stand in.
Cosma will stand in. He grounded out his first time. First pitch coming. Now the first pitch is in the air out toward right field. Hayward is there and he'll make the catch. Freddie Freeman will stand in to lead things off in the bottom of the fifth. Due to time constraints, we'll pick this one up in the top of inning number six. Adam Wainwright will lead things off for the Redbirds here in their half of the sixth inning. And a fairly generous strike ball there on the pitch that looked off the plate at strike one.
Yeah, a great sell job behind the plate, too. He sort of gently moved that glove back over an inch or two as he was catching that baseball.
And he misses 2-1. Here he comes on 2-1. Take that one a little bit low. Three balls and a strike now.
And you can't understate how important a leadoff base runner would be in a tie ball game. So this is a big pitch right here.
Tough pitch to lay off, but he did, and it's ball four, so the leadoff hitter is aboard to start the sixth. John James was stand in. Base on balls his last time. Ball hit high and foul down the left field line. It's strike one. Now the pitch. Now a possible double play ball for Ugla. To second for one. And now after that call at second, here comes the skipper out of the third base dugout as he apparently doesn't agree with the call. I believe the second base umpire is going to tell him that the drop occurred on the transfer, but that's not going to sit well with the skipper, so you can just about guarantee that he's going to have his say before he returns to the dugout. Carlos Beltran will get another shot. Struck out swinging his last time. First pitch fastball off the plate there, and it's ball one.
And no stolen bases for these guys just yet. You can credit that mostly to the fact they haven't had many guys on base.
Fastball again, but this one's by him for strike one. 1-1 down to Beltran. Down low, two balls and a strike.
Gotta credit their patience here in this inning. They're just letting him work himself into trouble.
Now a ground ball towards the hole. And a dive by Ugla, but it's by him for a base hit. Throw comes back in quickly, so put the runners at first and second now, still with only one away. So it's a tight spot here. First and second, one man out, and here's the left fielder, Matt Holliday. Now he gets the ground ball to first. This might be two. On to first, and they get the double play to get him out of the inning. Make it six shutout innings as he continues to give them fits out there. 2, 3, and 4 due up in the home half of the sixth, and we still... Martin Prado will dig in for the third time now. He struck out and bounced out. Time to move ahead to the top of inning number 7. Alan Craig is in for the third time now as he takes a called strike. It's 0-1.
And this is one of those guys that can break a tie with one swing at the bat.
A ball hit hard to the left side. And that's going to be a base hit. So there's the possible go-ahead run aboard to kick off the seventh.
Oh, and base runners are so precious this late in the game, especially leading off an inning. So now the possible go-ahead run's aboard.
David Freed is at the plate here as he quickly finds himself down to strike. It's 0-1. Oh, it's on the ground at second. Did he get his double play? From the first, and that's the fourth double play that comes into so far today. And with it, two are gone. So two are gone now for Yadi Arena. And he gets ahead here with the fastball, strike one. Now the pitch. Outside for a ball, 1-1. No runs, 5 hits, and no errors so far for the Redbirds. And this pitch misses for a ball, 2-1 now to Molina.
Yeah, even with the bases empty here and two away, you still need to be careful here, so he pitched him smart sometimes.
be afraid to work up in the zone against a guy like this. They want him to hit it in the air.
And now the lefty Eric O'Flaherty's up and throwing in the Braves bullpen. Not close. It's 2-0.
Now he's going to get a visit from his catcher just to make sure he's all right. But this might actually be more of a stall tactic here. I mean, his pitch count is starting to get up there, so this might just be to buy a little time for that bullpen.
And he pulled up in time, but it's a call on strike two.
He's closing in on putting up depth. Another zero.
There, and it's ball one. And I believe they'll say he broke the plate, and yes, he did. It's ruled a strike. Now a swing and a ground ball, but a foul ball. 1-2 the count now. ball away, and it's 2-0.
And you're in the part of the order here where mistakes can get magnified quickly, so you don't want to fall too far behind a guy like this.
Too high, and he misses again here, and it's 3-0 now.
Matty's come right out of the fence throwing nothing but balls. You better settle down quickly. In low here, ball one. And these guys better hope his location clears itself up pretty soon.
Ball two.
The one thing you can't do here, you can't lose him and load the bases. He's still got two pitches to play with, but I would expect this one to be in the zone.
Now it's Swain, a hard hit grounder. Molina will lead it off here in the top of inning number 10. First offering on the way. He sets the target in, and it finds the inside corner for strike one.
And his reward for a strong ninth inning is that he'll be allowed
number 8, to step in. He's 0-1 thus far. MLB 12 The Show. For more, log on to theshownation.com.